So at this point, we are done with Unit 1, and we've described what agent-based modeling is, why you might want to use it, what its advantages are, what some of the limitations might be, how it compares to potential other methods you're looking at, and even what you can use it for and what it can be used to accomplish, right? But what we haven't done, and what's probably most important, is we haven't described how to build an agent-based model, and we haven't described how to use that agent-based model once you've built it, right? And that's what the rest of this course is really going to be about. And so I'm really excited to start Unit 2, when we're going to dive into building a simple model and kind of illustrate how you might construct that model and how to start thinking like an agent-based modeler. And so at this point, I think it makes sense to take a brief pause and have you fill out a questionnaire where you will think through a model that you might want to explore, a model that you might want to take a look at during the time of this course, right? So I have a text file that has some questions. You can download, fill it out. I also have a Google survey that you can then go and you can provide some of those answers to me directly. And that kind of provides you with some ways to start thinking about the project in the model that you want to construct, right? And at the same time, since we're going to be jumping right into agent-based modeling and actually building agent-based models next time, I wanted to encourage you to go download the NetLogo software if you haven't done so already. Go through the tutorials. They're easy to find. They're in the documentation of the software. And if you want more additional information, you know, grab a copy of the book that I wrote with Uri on agent-based modeling. It's a great companion to this course. I highly recommend using this and other things to start to get you up to speed on how you might build your agent-based model, which is what we're going to be discussing in the very next unit.